A few advanced examples, the ones which actually are similar to the kind of questions you may be asked, even though these are still easier, but I will get to more complicated as we move, but little bit more advanced examples. So let's look at these two statements. My uncle is a loser because he is unemployed. And the second one is, my uncle is unlucky because he is unemployed. So let's look at each one of these. Now, in the first case, actually in both of them, the word because is the clue. We have already discussed that there are some clue words for the conclusion as well as for the premise. Sometimes you may be given one, or sometimes both, or sometimes neither. But still, the language should help you. Now, because here is helping us. So anything after because obviously is a reason. If it is the reason, it is the premise. So what is the premise of the first statement? The premise is that my uncle is unemployed. That is given as a reason. And from this reason, what has been concluded? Therefore, he is a loser. So therefore, we have added, but then we can easily add, because that is the deal. If he is saying that my uncle is a loser because he is unemployed, he is basically saying, you know what, since my uncle is unemployed, it proves that he is a loser. So therefore, he is a loser. Now, the better question to ask here is it a valid argument? Meaning, is it necessarily the case that if somebody is unemployed, it proves that that person is a loser? And you think about it, okay, as we move on. So if it is not sufficient, then obviously something is being assumed. And what is being assumed? That he is, you know, unemployed because of his laziness, or, you know, because of some negative trait in my uncle, he is unemployed, and therefore he is obviously a loser, you know, because since he cannot work hard, or he doesn't want to work hard, he is lazy, he is inept, whatever, all sorts of negative things you can come up with. So that is what is being assumed. And the argument against it is actually the second statement, you know, if you actually think about it. The second one is saying that my uncle is unlucky, you know. So you can rephrase the first and second statements in case that helps you better to understand how this is an argument. You can rephrase the first one as, you know, my uncle is lazy, after all he is unemployed. That's very similar to therefore. And similarly, my uncle is unlucky, after all he is unemployed. So both of them, now think about it, both of them are giving me the same reason, the same premise, that my uncle is unemployed. And both of them are coming up with two different conclusions. I think this should give you a hint as to why there is so much disagreement in the political arena, in the arena of morals, ethics, what should we do, what shouldn't we do, what is a good life, what should a country do in its policies, whether they are domestic or foreign, you know. Same premise can lead people to completely different conclusions because they are assuming completely different things. So the first person is assuming that it is because of some negative traits in my uncle, whereas the second one is saying no, it's just pure luck. So for what is the assumption of the second one? That he's unemployed because things didn't go his way. You know, he tried to get a job, he did whatever he could, but it's just that things just didn't go his way. He's unlucky. You know, so yeah, same premise, different conclusions. All right, okay, let's look at a still more advanced one. He's been smoking for the past 20 years, so obviously he's going to die of cancer. So now the first step is to make this into the form of an argument. What does it mean to make something into the form of an argument? This is the premise, this is the conclusion. So how do you do that? You can pause, do it on your own, and then we will move on. So the premise is, he's been smoking for the past 20 years, and the conclusion is easy here to understand because of the word so. So therefore, we have just rephrased it, therefore he's going to die of cancer. Why is he going to die of cancer? Because he has been smoking for the past 20 years. Now again, ask yourself this question, is this a valid argument? What does it mean? Is the premise or premises, is or are they sufficient to reach this conclusion? Pause, ask yourself. Okay, have you done that? The answer is obviously no. This premise alone does not lead to this conclusion. At least two things are being assumed. So before I tell you, try to do it on your own by pausing it and let's see. Okay, the first assumption is that smoking for around 20 years, meaning smoking, if you smoke for a long time, it necessarily leads to cancer. So smoking for around 20 years necessarily causes cancer. And the second assumption is that cancer necessarily causes death. You prove either one of these assumptions wrong, you have weakened the argument. You prove one or both of them correct, you have strengthened the argument. It is as simple as that. I told you beyond this, the only thing which will be, which will get difficult would be the language of the CR passage or paragraph that we will be given. The fundamentally, we won't have to do anything else. So basically, to be honest, CR would be a game of RC skills plus logic skills, but logic would be easier. I think a bigger challenge for most people would be comprehension of that passage. Okay, so RC as usual plays a role everywhere. I've already told this to you in another video. So these are the two assumptions which are being made. I have a question for you, and in case the answer to your to my question will be no, then I have some homework for you. By homework, I mean right now only. And that is, have you figured out a shortcut to do these questions? If you haven't, if you have, then you think about what you have thought, and let's see if it agrees with what I'm going to tell you. And if you haven't, please, please, please pause this video and see if you can figure out a shortcut to the questions, to the all each one of these three questions. There is a nice, I don't think if it is a shortcut as much as it is an amazing trick that you can utilize to verify whatever you're thinking is correct. Okay, the trick to verify whatever you think is the case is the case. Okay, if I sound cryptic, it's okay, you can ignore it and carry on with me. But if I make some sense to you, then pause it and think on these lines. Okay, all right, so here's the thing. There is a very amazing trick, and you can look at it as a shortcut to figure out whether, see, okay, I'm sorry, let me start from scratch. In these three types of questions, strengthen the above argument, weaken the above argument, and what is the assumption? The most important thing is finding the assumption. It is obvious, I think you agree to that. Every invalid argument in CR is invalid because there is a missing premise or premises. This missing premise or premises are known as assumptions. Unless you find the assumption, you can't move ahead. Why? Because if you want to strengthen it or find the assumption, you have to find the assumption for both. If you have to weaken it, you have to find the assumption and then pick up an answer choice which is the opposite of that assumption. So finding the assumption is the most important step. All right. Now here's an amazing trick to verify whether what you think is the assumption is actually true. And you can figure it out on your own without my telling you. So try doing it, but I will move on. Okay. It is known as negating the assumption technique. Basically what it means is that whatever you think is the assumption, in your mind you do the opposite, you say the opposite and see if something happens to the conclusion. If by negating what you think is the assumption, the conclusion is also harmed, it means you're right. Because remember, the conclusion depends on it. But if whatever you think is the assumption, and when you negate it, nothing happens to the conclusion, then at least you can be sure of the fact that what you think is not the assumption. What you think is the assumption is not the assumption, because if it were the assumption, negating it would harm the conclusion. Okay, so the elementary example, all roses are red, x is a all roses are red, therefore x is red. What is the assumption? X is a rose. Negated, x is not a rose. Is the conclusion harmed? Yes. Then how can you say directly that x is red? Well, then it means x is a rose is the assumption. And let's look at the other ones that we have done. So this example, my uncle is unemployed, therefore he is lazy. So since he's employed proves that he is lazy, the assumption was that he is unemployed because of his laziness. Okay, so negated, he is unemployed not because of his laziness, meaning you are saying there could be other reasons. The moment you do that, the conclusion therefore he is lazy falls apart. I mean, now it cannot stand anymore, because the assumption is that he's you are saying that he is lazy and the proof is that he's unemployed, but suddenly you say no, there could be other causes, then you have negated it. Let's look at the smoking example. He's been smoking for the past 20 years, so obviously he's going to die of cancer. Premise is smoking for the past 20 years, conclusion is therefore he's going to die of cancer. See the assumption, two assumptions, smoking necessarily causes cancer as in smoking for long, and cancer necessarily causes death. So now negate either or both one of them. So the first one, cancer may not necessarily cause death. If cancer may not necessarily, sorry, this was the second one, so let's look at it. So if cancer may not necessarily cause death, then even though he may get cancer, he may still not die. And similarly, if you look at the first assumption, smoking necessarily causes cancer, if you say that no, hang on, smoking may not, smoking for long, smoking for around 20 years may not cause cancer, then he may not even get cancer, forget dying, you know. So again, the conclusion falls apart. So this is a very, very nice trick to figure out whether what you think is the assumption is actually correct, is the assumption or not, okay. And so you negate it, and if the conclusion is harmed, you're right. If the conclusion is not harmed, you're wrong. And so you need to think about it more.